positive and passionate, and we're women who want to achieve a lot. So what I think our name has to project all that.
Sarah, if you can sell that, then I think you can sell anything.
When we did our screen test, Paul, who is the ultimate salesman out of all of us, just flopped, really.
Thank you very much, and goodbye.
Miriam, on the other hand, she was just such a natural. Yes, she was nervous, but she remained calm all the way through that.
313-534-2499. Ladies and gentlemen, don't miss out.
Sir Alan, the armchair critic, can watch his candidates in action live for the first time.
A bloody employer, that will. I'm telling you, she's very good. Bottom line of this task is who's taken the most amount of money, and that's going to really be because they've picked the right products. But from a sales point of view, you ain't going to get much better than what she's doing.
Miriam, I thought you were absolutely spectacular.
It was one of the hardest things I've ever done in my life.
Despite losing, I think Miriam was absolutely superb.
They said that with minimal training, she could get a job there.
Lose a task, and once again, having done absolutely everything I possibly could have done and given over 100% of myself, and to have lost is disappointing. I don't think anyone can assume that just because he complimented me in the boardroom on my presenting skills that I'm safe from being fired. If he wants to fire me, he'll find a reason to fire me.
Miriam could have carried off that job without either of them being at the end. I thought they added precious little.
Well, yeah. She's got a lot to answer to, Nick. No. I'm sorry.
The mistake
she's got a lot to answer
was
to.
Was not controlling them.
I'm struggling. But I'm even more sorry when I've got to tell you, Miriam, you're fired.
Thanks for the experience, it was amazing.
You know I've made mistakes in the past, and maybe I've made a mistake here, but we'll see.
Opportunity, business, collaboration, partnerships, these are all words that I feel very personally connected to about Birmingham. And I don't know if you know, but I'm a Midlands girl through and through. I don't quite have the accent nailed, but I grew up not too far down the road. But today is about networking and partnerships and being inspired by the messages that you're going to hear from the speakers, having a little bit of something that maybe you can go away and apply to the businesses that you all are part of and that maybe you run. But above all, being open to potentially some new thinking and a new way of maybe integrating some of the changes in the landscape into the way that business is done in this day and age. So I hope that you're excited. Are you excited? I was excited just watching the video. But what we have done is put together a group of speakers who've all got some very specific business messages for you that you're going to be able to absorb and adapt and take back with you to your colleagues, to your industries, and hopefully see an increase in your success simply because you've been inspired today by the things that they've gone through, the lessons that they've learned, and what that can then mean to you. I was very struck by the final point, that piece about courage. I don't know if you've had to exhibit courage in your lives, in your business careers, that those pinnacle moments, aren't there, where you think, actually, I can do this, but I can only do it if, oh my goodness, I rally myself and I gather all of that internal courage in order to take a step, to take a leap. And I love the link between that point being one of the mechanisms with which we can manage change, that we can continue to exploit opportunities.
Elevation,
yeah. How are we actually going to elevate to understand what business we're really in? Such a crucial point can change the opportunities around us. What else? Anything from this side?
Disruption,
and that it's going to hit, and that actually we can't escape it, yeah. Anyone else?
Buy good ores.
Is there an analogy for life in that, Ross? Buy good ores. Yeah, I think there's a lot of analogies in there. One more that's really struck with you so far.
Courage.
Absolutely, courage. Finding the grit, finding the internal courage, taking that step, taking that leap, which is what he helps his clients around the world with. He speaks internationally, he's spoken on 5 continents for many, many years. He's a seasoned professional, and he's going to wake up our thinking after lunch around this whole concept of celebrity service. So without any further ado, I would love you to welcome to stage Jeff Ram. In a way which enables you to take action rather than being blocked by our own limitations and our own thinking about the way that we perceive things to be. So yes, rules exist. Yes, we work in environments where there are rules, But are there things within that that you can allow yourself not to be limited by in order to take every opportunity to build a windmill, to build the right people, to get the best out of yourself, to close those gaps? And I'd really like to leave you with that thought.